गाइस वेलकम टू आवर कम्युनिटी कोडेको। इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल वी आर गोइंग सी इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट आवर प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज। हियर वी आर गोइंग सी फोर टॉपिक्स। इन फर्स्ट टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाई वी आर गोइंग फॉर आवर प्रोग्रामिंग। इन सेकंड टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट आर द फ्यूचर्स ऑफ आवर प्रोग्रामिंग। इन थर्ड टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ आवर प्रोग्रामिंग। In fourth topic, we are going to discuss about what are the applications of R programming. Let us start with small introduction about R programming. So R is a programming language and software environment for statistical analysis, graphics representation and reporting. So in general, R environment we are going to use like getting the data from database or getting the data from other resources and analyzing the data and getting the result in the form of graphs and then reporting it, okay? And R is available across widely used platforms like Windows, Linux and macOS. So here it is not restricted, like we have to have Windows to work with R or you have to have Linux if you are learning R. It's not like that. If you have an operating system, you can easily install it and we can easily learn it, okay? R programming language is the latest cutting edge technology or latest cutting edge tool for data science and data analysis. If you are interested in these fields, you have to learn R programming, because nowadays it is growing and everyone is learning who is interested in those fields, because it is widely used in those fields, okay? And now we will start. Why R programming language? In this tutorial, we are going to focus on this few topics. So why we are going for this language? Let us take a look into each and everything. R programming is used as a leading tool for machine learning, statistics and data analysis. So as I said, if you are interested in these fields, R programming is best to learn and work with these fields, okay? And we can easily create objects, functions and one more thing, packages. So in R itself we have hundreds and thousands of packages, and also we can create our own package very easily. That is the most important thing in R programming, okay? And it's a platform independent language. What's the meaning of platform independent? As I said before, it is not restricted like we have to use in particular operating system. If we have an operating system, we can easily access it, okay? And it is an open source free language. In the sense, we no need to purchase the license or we no need to pay any money to use that software, and we no need to be in specific organization to use it, okay? You can freely access from the browser and we can download it and we can learn from the browser itself also, okay? And R programming language is not only a statistic package but also allows us to integrate with other languages like C, C++. Thus, you can easily interact with many data sources and statistical packages. What I am saying here is, if in previous days, the data is going to be stored in C, C++ languages, right? So if you want to retrieve the data or if you want to work with the data, we can easily do by using R programming, because it is interacting with those programming languages very easily. And R programming language has vast community of users and it's growing day by day. Why I am saying this? Because nowadays data science, data analysis, machine learning is growing day by day. The technology is growing. So who is interested in those technologies? They all are learning R programming. So it is very easy to find someone and we can learn very easily. Okay. And R is currently one of the most requested programming languages in the data science job market. This is, if you are interested in data science job, you have to learn R programming language, because it is very easy and also it is widely used in data science jobs for analyzing and doing statistics, okay? So this makes its hottest trend nowadays. Now we will see features of R programming language. Here we are going to see two features. One is statistical features and second one is programming features. In statistical features, we are going to see three different types of features. And in programming features, we are going to see two different types of features. Let us take a look into what are those features, okay? See, in statistical features, we have basic statistics, statistic graphs, probability distributions. And in programming features, we have R packages, distributed computing. Let us take a look into each and every statistics. So, first we will take a look into basic statistics, okay? The most common basic statistics terms are the mean, mode and median. By using our programming, we can do these things very, very, very easily. This is also known as measures of central tendency. So, using the R language, we can measure central tendency very easily. So, that is basic statistics. And now, we will take a look into statistic graphs. R is rich with facilities for creating and developing interesting statistic graphs. R contains functionality for many plot types, including graphic maps, bioplots, so on. So, as I said earlier, it is very, very interesting to work with R programming language because of this specific topic. We can very, very clearly see the result in term of graphs, and it is very developed and it is well created, because we can see very clearly the graphics of the graph, okay. So, and also we have different type of plots like circles, bars, lines and everything, dots, okay, and so on. You can work with those later, okay. And third thing, probability distribution. Probability distribution play a vital role in statistics, and by using R we can easily handle various types of probability distribution such as binomial distribution, normal distribution, chi-squared distribution and many more. In general, if you are doing binomial distribution or normal distribution, it is very hard for us to do, right? It will take a lot of time. But if you use this R programming language, it's going to be very easy, and that's why it's very simple to write itself also. We are not going to suffer or we are not able to understand. It is very simple lines of code to get the result, okay. And now we will take a look into programming features. First we will see R packages. One of the main features of R is it has a wide variety or availability of libraries. Here we have to learn what is the library stands for and how it works and what's the main specifications of that library. Then we can easily work with R language. The only one thing we have to do here, just we have to know what the package means and what's the inside the package and how it works, for what it works, okay. R has CRNA, in sense comprehensive R achieve network, which is a repository holding more than 1 lakh packages, you have to remember. So, in this repository, you can type this Google comprehensive R achieve network packages, you can get it and you can learn, okay. And you can download R software from this website also. Now, we will take a look into distributed computing. Is a model in which components of a software system are shared among multiple computers to improve efficiency and performance. Two new packages, DDR and MultiDR or Multiply, I used for distributed programming in R, were released in November 2015. So, these two packages is most efficient and performed among multiple computers, okay. Now take a look into advantages. What are the advantages for using or by using R programming language? R is the most comprehensive statistic analysis package. A new technology and component often appear first in R programming. So in before, we had not seen in Python also, those technology is built in R programming. So it is very, very new. If you are learning R programming, there are so many concepts in R that we had not learned in our previous programming languages. As R programming language is an open source, thus you can run R anywhere and at any time. That you have to remember, it is an open source. For most of the programming languages, we have to buy the software, or after some time we have to buy, but here no need to buy. It is just we can access it and we can run it. Okay. And R programming language is suitable for GNU, Linux and Windows operating system. So it is acceptable in all operating systems in general. Okay. And R programming is cross platform, which runs on any operating system. As what I had said now, in R, everyone is welcome to provide new packages, bug fixes and code enhancements. As I said, we can create our new packages and we can bug our fixes, or if any bugs is there, we can fix it. Okay. What are the disadvantages then? See, the main disadvantages in R programming language, the standard of some packages is less than perfect. So sometimes the package may work or may not. So that small miscommunication is going to be there between packages. Okay. And then although R commands give little pressure to memory management, so R programming language may consume all available memory. Okay. So it consumes a lot of memory. So that is also main disadvantage of R programming. Let us see applications of R programming. We use R for data science. As I said, it gives us a broad variety of libraries related to statistics. We know R programming language have more than 100,000 packages. So in that packages, we have variety of statistics packages. Okay. It also provides the environment for statistical computing and design. And R is used by many quantitative analysis as its programming tool. Thus, it helps in data importing and cleaning. See, it's very easy to import the data and clean the data and also analyze the data. That's why in quantitative analysis, the programmers using R programming. Okay. And R is the most prevalent language. So, many data analysis and research programmers use it. Hence, it is used as a fundamental tool for finance. So it's very easy for our statistical, machine learning, data science, data analysis fields. So everyone is using, even data analysis using and research programmers also using it, because it's mainly depends on the finance. Okay. And tech giants like Google, Facebook, Wipro and many more using R programming nowadays. And this is also one of the applications here. That's it for today's tutorial. We will meet in another tutorial.